Hello guys, welcome back to my channel. So today we will learn in this video how to add domain user or group to the local system administrator group. Means if you have a domain controller and if there are a lot of machines in your domain environment, and client machine, and if you want to add domain user or group to the client machine administrator group, so I will show you how you can add through group policy. But before go ahead, I want to request you, please subscribe my channel. If you not subscribe yet, means if you are new for my channel, so I'll request you to please subscribe. And if this video will be informative, please like and share. So let us start now. I'm going to open the Active Directory users and computers. Here you can see Active Directory users and computers. This is my domain controller DC server. So I have opened Active Directory users computers because I want to show you how you can create group or how you can add already created group to the local system administrator group. So I have here few group like help desk, tech support, test admin group. So suppose if you want to add this test admin group to the client machine local administrator group, or you can say client machine administrator group. So here I want to show you, this is my client machine, that IP is 10.10.8, and you can see guys, I am trying to show you step by step, so maybe this video will be long, because yes, it will be beneficial. So you can see here the domain is test.lan. so this machine is client machine, and we'll check here lusr ngr.msc. through this command you can open local user and groups, or you can open this by right click on system or this PC, go to manage option. So here I am going to administrator group, and you can see here that there are three group: domain admin, help desk, tech support. So suppose if you want to add another group in this administrator group, so I am here on my DC server, and you can see the test admin group. This is not added in administrator group of client machine. I want to show you again. You can see here there is no any test admin group. So let us jump on DC. So now we'll try to add this through group policy management. You can implement policies through default domain policies, but please take care. If you will implement or modify default domain policy, it will be implement on all your client machine. So if you want to apply for individual or separate machine, means one or two machines only, so you have to create OU and create new group policy and link. So for now I am going to implement here, means through default domain admin policy. If you will create new policy, then you have to follow the same process. And if you have any query, you can comment. I will try to help you. So guys, you have to modify this default domain policy. Go to edit option, You can see here there are two policies, computer configuration and user configuration. So you have to make changes in computer configuration policies. Here preferences, control panel setting, you can see here local user and groups. So what you have to do, you have to right click here, or you can also right click here, new. If you want to add local user to the administrator group or group, then you have to select accordingly. If you want to add user, then you need to select local user. If you want to add group, then you have to select local group. So here I want to add group, so I am going to select here local group. You have to keep this option update. If you have to create, then you can select create option, or if you want to just add already created user or group to the administrator group. So here we have already created one local group, that is test admin. And group name, here you have to select where you want to add. So we have to add this on administrator group built-in, so we'll select administrator, or if you want to add in another group, then you have to select accordingly. Here there are many option, so I am selecting here administrator. You can enter here any name if you want to rename, otherwise leave it as blank. And here, from here you can add the member or group. So I am going to here select test group. Yes, so you can see a test admin group, and this group we are going to add to the client machine administrator group. Just click OK. OK, here you can see test, domain name is test, test admin group, and action add SID is this for this group. Apply. OK, just close it and run GP update. So you can see here updating policies, computer policy updater has completely successfully, user policy update has completely successfully. So as policy has been updated now, so we'll check on client machine. So here you can see there is no any test admin group. So to update policy, we'll run here GP update. Yes, so you can see computer policy update has completed successfully, user policy update has completed successfully. So now we'll check if test admin group is added in this administrator group or not. But before showing you the result, I want to ask one question. Question is that in which group policy we have added or modified user or group, in computer configuration policies or user configuration policies? So please give me answer by comment. Now I want to show you. Yes, so you can see here the test admin group is added now in this client machine administrator group. So guys, I think this video is informative for you, and this will be really helpful and very clear to you, because I have tried on my best level. So let us finish now. And I'll again request you to please subscribe my channel and like, and please don't forget to click on bell icon. Thank you, bye bye.